Tigger and Pooh, and a musical too.
Someone who has extra honey pots.
Someone who joins in your pirate crew.
Yes, I'm awfully glad I've got friends like you.
One
big happy
family.
I've got you.
And you've got me.
Divided?
Never.
Friends?
Forever. One big happy family.
Catches you when you fall.
Someone who makes you forget you're small.
Someone who's proud, whatever you do.
I'm ever so glad I've got friends like you.
One
big happy
family.
I've got you.
And you've got
me.
Divided?
Never!
Friends!
Forever! One big happy family. One big happy family. Yes,
we are one big happy family. Oh, you know, I just love being all familiar with my family. Except the ants. I mean, uncles are one thing, but... Oh, Bala.
Don't worry. I've got everything taken care of. All we need is my patented anti-antifier.
Whoa!
Yes. Guaranteed to keep ants away from your picnic food or double your honey back.
Pardon me, but does anyone have a napkin?
Oh, would you like regular or heffa-sized?
Great seed, Spittin' Lumpster. Now let me try.
Better go with this one.
Oh, my goodness, Rabbit. You thought of everything.
Well, planning is one of my favorite things to do.
If it weren't for you, I never would have made a big enough cheese ball.
Ooh, and I wouldn't have cooked enough goulash for everyone. Rabbit sure knows how to put together a picnic.
That's a fact. He even told me to start walking here yesterday so I wouldn't be late today.
Rabbit helped Buster and me plan the decorations.
Best picnic I've been invited to. Only picnic I've been invited to.
You did a great job organizing this picnic, Rabbit. We know how hard you work to get everything together.
Almost as hard as a beaver works.
So we all decided to thank you.
Thank me?
By making you the first ever grand and bestest mayor of the whole 100-acre wood.
Ooh, I don't know what to say.
Oh, this is a special occasion.
Oh, thank you, everyone. You know, it's worth all the effort it took just to see all my friends so happy.
You mean we know a real mayor?
Awesome! What's a mayor?
Well, isn't it oblivious? He is the one with the fancy schmancy hat.
That's not all a mayor is, Tigger. They're like the boss of the wood. Mayors are in charge of everything.
Did you say everything?
Yeah, that's how they make a place better for everyone who lives there.
Well, now that you mention it, I do have a few small suggestions on how to make things better, yes.
I rather think things are already wonderful.
But why settle for wonderful when things can be perfect? Now, let me see. I've got a thought, or maybe two or three.
Is anybody worried but me?
Since more order and control are what we need, here are some simple rules, just a few, for us to heed. No pecking twice on trees, and no bothering the bees. And regarding Beaver's Dam, there's this decree. Building dams requires a permit, and a foreman to confirm it. And that foreman, quite conveniently, is me.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
I guess those rules aren't too bad.
Something tells me he's not done yet.
Wait, lunch is promptly served at noon. A minute earlier is too soon. And Pooh, I know you'll love this suggestion. There's too much honey in your diet. Eat some veggies. Go on, try it. You'll thank me, and so will your digestion.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Now, Tigger, as I'm sure you predicted, your bouncing is restricted to 30 minutes daily, more or less. Try something else instead, making pots or baking bread. With no bouncing, we'll all enjoy some rest.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Hello, Rabbit.
Oh, no.
Is something wrong?
It's not sweeping time. It's dishwashing time. That's why I brought you an extra scrub brush.
Thank you, Rabbit. But all of my dishes are already washed.
That doesn't matter. All chores are to be done at the same time all over the wood. It's simply more organized.
If you say so, Rabbit.
My daily schedule shows when to rake or blow your nose. You'll know to hoe or leave your peas alone. But I can cite no greater crime than to sweep at sleeping time or to use a schedule different from my own.
What time is it now, Rabbit?
Time to sing the chorus, of course.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Just a few simple rules to follow to a T, and what a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Rabbit, I think the problem is you're the only one who knows all the rules.
Oh, you're absolutely right, Darby. I should post them where everyone can see their genius. I'll be back for sock sorting time, Piglet.
But I don't wear socks!
Ta-da! A full list of all the new Mayor Rabbit rules to live by.
Whoa! I don't think I can remember all those rules.
No butterfly tag after 3 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. Butterflies require rest, you know.
Poo sticks will be played every day from 2 to 4. Oh, but what if we want to play it in the morning?
Don't worry, you won't.
No permitting, flitting, crossed, leg sitting, quitting, quilting, or knitting?
Trust me on that one.
That's an awful lot of rules, Rabbit.
And a lot of rules that are awful.
Now, I know this is going to take a little adjustment on everyone's part, but think of what a perfect place we can make the wood. Just a few simple rules to follow to a T. What a splendid 100-acre wood this will be.
Start off today with a hearty hop and a bouncer sizing. Almost forgot. Rabbit says I'm only allowed to bounce a little bit every day. So maybe I'd better save my bouncity for later. Nah.
Why aren't you wearing your bouncer blocker shoes?
Well, they're previously engagerated. See?
Your bouncing session doesn't start until 10 o'clock. No bouncing before then.
Yeah. Thanks for clearing that up, Rara. What?
All right. Come ahead. Cross traffic.
Is it time yet? Is it about the time? Well.
What? Oh, Tigger, yes, fine. Your bouncing session begins now.
Oh, Tigger. Thanks, long ears.
Darby, would you be so kind? When the sand runs out from the top, it's time for Tigger to stop bouncing.
Okay, Rabbit, but I'm not sure it's going to be so easy for Tigger to...
Porcupine! No stopping in the middle of the bridge.
Well, I didn't even know I was in the middle.
Here you are, Porcupine dear.
Oh, thank you.
Remember, rules make things easier for everyone.
With a thingity, thingity pound.
Stop! Time's up, Tigger!
Already? Are you sure? Hey, I have an idea. Why don't I just turn the sandy glass upside down and start bouncing all over again? Long ears, I'll never... What's wrong with this thing?
It can't be restarted until tomorrow. That's it, Tigger. You've used up all your bouncing for today.
But now what do I do?
Well, that's not my concern. I have too many mayor duties to attend to. Uneasy lies the head that wears the straw hat. I hope you're not looking for more honey, Pooh.
Bother.
Pooh, I told you, ceaseless honey hunting is inefficient. Whenever you crave honey, have one of these instead. Pre-cleaned and peeled. I prepared several pots for you.
Oh, thank you, Rabbit.
Tigger, why do you keep following me around?
Well, what else am I supposed to do?
Something, anything, but you can't follow me around all day. Tigger!
What?
Nicely done. You've passed my safety inspection. Your dam is very well built.
Don't need a piece of paper to tell me that.
I admire your hard work, Beaver. There may be a place for you in my administration.
You mean I could be a...
That's right. Deputy Mayor Beaver.
Oh, well.
Keep up the good work. Work, work. Tigger! Please, didn't I ask you to? Help! Tigger, don't you have to answer the sleuth siren?
Well, it's kind of hard if I can't bounce right into the changing tree because of the roof.
But, okay.
Slap my cat. Sounds like somebody needs our help.
Anytime, any place.
The super sleuths are on the case. And the finder flag says we need to go to
my house. But I'll save you the trip, because the problem is right here. Tigger is driving me crazy. He follows me wherever I go.
Well, I'm sorry, long ears, but if I can't bounce, there's not much else for me to do, is there?
You can do whatever you want. Clean your house, make pottery, anything, as long as you leave me alone. Oh, please, Super Sleuth, for my sanity, can you just make Tigger forget about bouncing?
Well, we'll do our best, Rabbit.
Oh, thank you. Oh, look. Now I'm way off schedule. I've got to make sure Turtle's on time for his hula lessons.
It's okay, Tigger. We'll help you keep your mind off bouncing.
Well, thanks. Enough feeling sorry for myself. Tiggers can do anything, or not do anything, if they put their minds to it, or don't. Come on! We'll have a blast, and I won't even mention the word.
Oh, bouncing, bouncing, bouncing.
Those were the good old days.
Kind of cheers me up just thinking about it.
I love to bounce. Bouncing, life is great when you are bouncing. I'm way overdue for bouncing. It's what Tiggers do the best. Bouncing, long-eared types say foo to bouncing. There's no thing as too much bouncing. It's what Tiggers do the best. Once you start with bouncing, you gotta bouncety bounce some more. Cause there's no treat that's half as sweet as tail meat and floor. Let me show you. Bouncing when I'm feeling blue. And bouncing is what pulls me through. Cause bouncing is what Tiggers do to best. Once you start with bouncing, you gotta bounce, bounce, bounce some more. Cause there's no treat that's half as sweet as tail meat and floor. Let's show them. Bouncing in the rain, hoo-hoo. Bouncing, oh, my love is true. With bouncing, it's what Tiggers do the best.
You know, some may try to tell you that bouncing is not refined.
But just let loose with your caboose and leave them all behind and do some bouncing. I can't say you do to bouncing.
Thanks, but I'll stick to
my bouncing. It's what Tiggers do the best. If I had one wish, it'd be pudding
and a squeezy toy. But then I wish for 12 more meals so we could all enjoy.
Bouncing, he can get enough. Bouncing, watch him strut his stuff. While bouncing, you may say that he's obsessed. He's obsessed.
But a duck's gotta quack, a cow's gotta moo, a tinker's gotta do what he's born to do, and that's
bouncing.
Just what I'm talking about.
Bouncing.
Did I happen to mention?
Bouncing is what tiggers do. The best.
Bouncing is what tiggers do. Bouncing is what tiggers do.
There, Rabbit. I am so sorry. Sorta.
Look what you've done. You're not even supposed to be bouncing.
Sorry, Rabbit, but you just can't stop a ticker from bouncing.
Or perhaps keeping a ticker from bouncing just isn't possible.
Pooh, that's my honey.
Really? It tastes as good as the bees make, Rabbit.
What's going on?
We heard a whole bunch of noise.
Lumpy, Roo, why aren't you napping? Can't anyone around here follow rules?
Well, no offense, long ears, but your rules are much fun to follow, if you follow me.
Well, of course they're not fun. That's why they're called rules.
I think what we've got here is one of your basic philosophical differences. Per se.
I give up. If you don't like my rules, then fine. Make up your own rules.
Really? You mean I get to be mayor? Ooh, I can't wait to get one of these hats.
Yes, you can be mayor on your half of the 100-acre wood.
Tigger's half? What do you mean?
But, Rabbit, you're dividing the 100-acre wood?
Right down the middle. Everyone who lives on my side of the line, Kanga, Roo, Eeyore, Turtle, and myself, will continue following my rules. And everyone who lives on the wrong, that is, the other side, that would be you, Tigger, and Pooh, Porcupine, and Lumpy, you can make whatever rules you like.
Really? Well, then, the first official rule is everybody gets to bounce as much as they want, whenever they want, wherever they want, all the time, whether they want to or not, anytime, starting now. I love being mayor.
I don't think this is such a good idea. Do you?
I continue painting the line exactly as it is on the map, Deputy Beaver.
Understood, Your Honor.
But what about me and Buster Rabbit? We're not on your map.
You two are welcome on this side whenever you like.
Well, I'm sure she's appreciative and all, but I know Dar Dar and Buster Boy will be wanting to spend time over here with Mayor Tigger.
Won't you?
Gosh. I don't know. I mean, you're all my friends. Oh, I hate to have to choose.
And what about Piglet?
Oh, my! But
Rabbit said to follow the map exactly. Afternoon, Piglet.
Oh, did it hear?
Hello, Piglet. Glad to see you're on my side of the wood.
What? I've
made out your schedule for the rest of the day.
Oh, Why, thank you, Rabbit.
Let's see, 10:45, tidy the house, 11:15, scrapbook assembly, noon, lunchtime, of course.
I do like knowing how I'm going to spend my day.
Hello, Tiggerletto.
Hello, Tigger.
Welcome to Tiggerville, where it's all buzzing all the time. What do you think of my mayor hat? It's the tops, huh? Talk to me.
Piglet. Oh, Piglet. If you'll just step out here to this side of your yard, we'll finish going over your schedule.
Did somebody say something? Because I got a schedule for you, too. Let's see now. Fun. And later we'll have fun. And then lunch followed by some, let me see. Oh, yeah. Fun.
Piglet, whatever Tigger tells you, just remember, the grass is always greener on the other side.
That's right. My side.
No, that's not what I meant.
Our grass is greenier, our scenery's scenier.
The beans in my garden are far more beanier.
Bouncing all day and the day never ends over here.
Over here
with me and my friends.
Our days are sunnier.
Our jokes are funnier. All of the bees in our trees are honeyer.
Organized fun makes a day worry-free.
Here with my buddies and me. We got no rules against flouncing or fun. Being late's not the greatest of crimes. No,
time to stop bouncing now, Tigger. I mean it.
Is that how I sound?
Well, sometimes.
Over here, veggies grow in neatly spaced rows, and our weather is sublime. And you can be certain that if we had trains, they would surely run on time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Our skies are bluer.
Our carrots chewier.
The bears that reside on our side are pooier. No rules to break, only ones you can bend. Over here with me and my friends. A mayor with stripes is chic, don't you know? Stripes give one their certain zing.
A mayor who might suddenly bounce on your head.
You say that like it's a bad thing.
Tagulars, woozles, grints, and gabloons, so much and so many to fear. Here's a list of reasons you should be afraid. Thank goodness it's safe over here. Our birds sing prettier.
Our cats are kittier.
You find it most times that our rhymes are wittier.
Noah's a message that nobody sends over here.
Over here with me and my friends.
Your bugs are bitier.
Your side's untidier.
It's very well known our side's bona fideier.
One out of two happy squirrels agree. Ours is the side that you simply must see.
The sun never sets and the fun never sleeps. A Tigger in time, you and me and my peeps.
Over here.
Over here.
Over here.
Over here.
Over here.
Over here. Over here with me and my friends.
My friends.
No, my friends.
Over here.
I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings, so I'll just stay here, thanks. Go away! Please!
It's me, Piglet. Or rather, it's me, Pooh Bear. Piglet.
Oh, Pooh Bear. I'm awfully glad to see you.
Do you mind if I come inside half of your house?
Make yourself half at home.
Thank you. Oh, bother. I was afraid of that. Your honey is on Rabbit's side of the line. I don't suppose...
Of course, Pooh Bear. I'd be happy to bring you some.
Mayoral Decree 73 says very clearly, here, let's see if I place it away, no trading or bartering goods or material across the white line.
Which means...
None of Piglet's honey for you.
I'm sorry, Pooh Bear, but if Rabbit says so...
Well, that's all right, Piglet. I'm happy just to visit with you. Would you like a carrot?
Well, glad to see you picked our side, Darby.
Huh? Oh, no. Buster and I didn't pick a side. We just...
Visiting. You belong here, our side.
Oh, no. Darby's got much better taste than that.
Exactly. Look where she's standing.
All this line does is make people argue with each other. I guess we'll just have to walk right down the middle.
Hey,
Lumpy, drop them. Here goes. Well, whose stick came up first?
I can't tell whose is who. It's kind of hard playing poo sticks like this.
Not as much fun either.
It doesn't sound like anybody's happy about the slime, huh, boy?
The Sleuther siren! We gotta get Tigger and Pooh.
Pooh Bear! Sounds like somebody needs our help.
The siren is a-calling to the changing tree.
Thanks for coming by, Pooh. A happy sleuthing.
Piglet!
Dum-dum-dum-da-dum-dum. Dum-dum-dum-da-dum-dum. Dum-dum-dum-da-dum-dum.
Aha! Hold it right there. Darby, you and Buster are okay to cross. Rabbit said you can come and go as you please.
Thanks, Beaver. Come on, sleuths.
Up, 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 up. Just a minute there. You two young fellas gotta stay on your own side.
But, Beaver, the sleuths have to get to the changing tree.
Oh. Well, that presents a bit of a problem, doesn't it? Seeing as how the changing tree's on our side of the line and all. Tell you what, if you say the right password, I'll let you through.
The right password.
Ha! Thought you could fool me. Not that easy, Bear.
It's like a secret signal.
Yeah, special word that only people on our side know.
How do they find out what the password is?
Well, suppose you could try guessing the password.
Oh, Darby, perhaps you and Buster should go ahead to the changing tree to see who needs our help.
Yeah, we'll be right behind you. Guessing passity words is what Tiggers do best, you know.
Good idea. I'll go slap my cap and check out the finder fly. See you soon.
Well, any guesses?
Is the password honey?
Nope.
Oh, bother.
Oh, that's not it either.
Step aside there, Pooh boy. Let a pro into no try. We'll be crossing that line in no time. The password is... Rumpelstiltskin.
Now, kumquat. Ah.
Swordfish?
No.
Sandwich?
No.
Frangipan?
Nope.
Monkey? Guppy? Panda? Puppy? Jaguar? Gefilte fish? Poodle? Rumpadoodle? Chicken noodle? In a strudel dish? Crocus or chrysanthemum? Chinchillas? Chocolate chewing gum? Lima beans?
No.
Linoleum?
Nope.
Or elbows? Fingers? Toes? Thumbs? It probably isn't stripies. But it could be polka dot.
No.
It might be armadillo. But I kind of think it's not. Kaleidoscope or kindergarten. Easter bunny, Santa Claus. Doorbell or dirigible. Spaghetti with some applesauce. Dental floss, rhinoceri. Colossal hippopotami. From Uncle Cake, pumpkin pie. I'm running out of words to try.
If we try to think like a rabbit thinks.
Yeah, but he doesn't. Ooh, that's it. I finally got it. The password must be carrot, right?
Sorry.
That's okay. I got a lot of more. Robin, sparrow, bow and arrow, Oreo, the barricade, llamas, comets, striped pajamas, Nicky Dicky, sticky feet, palomino, chilibino, cappuccino, cherry jam, penguin, squirrel, boy and girl, cellophane or telegram, haberdasher, pop and G, maroon or mamma mia, or interplatitudinoid.
What's that?
I've no idea. Is it eggs and bacon?
No.
For so forsaken?
No.
Wagons, ho, dragons?
No.
Cat, hat, bat, mat?
No.
I got it.
Never mind.
Oh, bother.
That's still not it.
Sorry. That was every word I know. And even some I don't. Wait a minute. Where do you think you're going?
Gotta get some branches down near the creek over on your side.
Tut-tut-tut-tut-tut! Not without the Tiggerville password, you don't.
Oh, Oh.
Now, hold on.
He'll never get this.
Is the password, Tigger?
Told you what.
How'd you do that? Go get your sticks.
I miss Gopher.
Hate to be a bother.
Helping friends is never a bother, Eeyore. What's the problem?
Kinda hungry is all. All the thistles grow on Tigger's side of the white line.
Gosh, this big white line seems to be causing more problems than it solves. Don't worry, Eeyore. We'll be back in a flash. I'm glad Lumpy and Roo are still getting along.
Got it! Got it! There.
That's funny. Your grass doesn't look any greener than ours.
What do you mean?
Rabbit says the grass on your side is greener, but Tigger says ours is. I think he's right. Yes, definitely. Ours is greener.
I don't know. I think maybe Rabbit's right. Ours is greener.
A little, anyway. Well?
Well?
I'd better go now.
Okay. See ya.
Oh, my. I think everyone needs some cheering up. And I know how.
Found a good mayor hat yet, Tigger?
Ooh, what about this one? It just kind of screams mayor, doesn't it? Hey, look! I'm Lumpy! Ooh, I am liking this one.
Tigger, doesn't it bother you that our friends can't even talk to each other anymore?
Are you kidding? I finally get to bouncerize with no rabbit eruptions.
And I do prefer eating honey on my own schedule, which is, all the time.
Although, I do kind of miss seeing Roo Boy, and Kanga, and Eeyore. I wonder how he is.
Hungry.
I'm sure Eeyore must miss us as much as we miss him.
And you know, I hate to admit it, but I even miss old Long Ears yelling at me. The day seems kind of empty without it, but I'll get over it.
What is it, Pooh?
Well, unless I'm mistaken, it's Kanga's cookies.
Hello, Pooh.
Hello, everyone.
I was hoping you might be here.
Kanga!
Hi, Kanga.
I haven't seen you all in so long. I wanted to give you these.
Oh, I've missed your cookies so much, Kanga. And you too, of course. But I don't think Rabbit's rules allow us to have these.
Well, I'm the mayor of these here parts, and I say it's okay.
Thank you, Your Honorableness.
Thanks, Tigger.
I think it's just terrible that we can't all be together.
Yeah, but Rabbit wanted the big white line, so that's how it's gonna be.
But Rabbit must see what a hard time everybody's having with it.
You're right, I do. And that's why I've decided to do something guaranteed to cheer everyone up. Everyone on my side, that is. Fellow citizens, that is Kanga and Roo, since our last picnic did such a wonderful job of making everyone happy, I'm pleased to announce another picnic. Even bigger and better than the last. Isn't that wonderful?
Oh, yeah? Because we were just going to have a picnic on our side, too. Bigger and better and more picnickier, too.
Fine.
Finer.
Wait, Rabbit! Tigger! Everybody! I don't know what to do. I want to be with all my friends, but they don't seem to want to be with each other. Which picnic do you think we should go to? I guess we'll just have to go to both picnics.
Come on, everyone. This is going to be the best picnic in the history of the Hundred Acre Wood. The Tigger side couldn't possibly be more fun than this. I propose a toast to the safest, happiest, most orderly place there is. Here. This lemonade is sour.
Who always added the honey?
Well, at least we have Kanga's delicious cookies. Huh?
I'm afraid I couldn't bake any rabbit. All the butter is on the other side of the line.
Oh. Still, that won't stop us from having a wonderful picnic.
You said it. Now, how's about we forget our troubles and play some good old-fashioned games?
Games?
Yeah, you know, like Duck Duck Goose.
That sounds messy.
Or pin the tail on me.
Tigger always organized the games, Roo dear.
I wish he were here, and Lumpy too. Maybe we could invite them. I'm sure it'd be more fun for everyone.
We don't need them to have a good time. Remember?
One big happy family.
I've got you.
When
you've got me.
Divided?
Never. Forever.
One big happy family. One big happy family.
Hey, everybody! Oops. Sorry there, ma'am.
Bouncing is what Tiggers do to best.
Tigger, is this all the food for the picnic?
Yep. Have as much as you want, but want as much as you have. Something.
These ants certainly are helping themselves.
I don't suppose you can do anything about that, Tigger.
Well, hello there, little bugaloos. Are you having fun?
Well, good, because that's what this picnicking is all about.
Well, that's not exactly what I meant.
Hey, Tigger, how's the picnic going?
Even better now that you're here, Dar-Dar. We can start playing games.
Brilliant!
But I don't see any soccer balls or watermelon seeds. There's nothing to play.
Oh, dear. I think someone forgot the potato salad.
And the picnic table.
And the balloons.
Tigger, why didn't you say you needed decorations?
Well, to tell you the truth, Rara was always kind of the plannerer. Let me see. Wonder what he'd say if he was here right now.
Quit looking in my windows.
Yeah, that's it, all right. Oh, and then he'd say, it's sing-along time! Big, happy...
You...
What?
You...
I guess pickety-nicking is on the not what Tiggers do best list.
I bet if we invited everyone from the other side, the picnic would be fun again.
Fun? With long ears telling me not to bounce? No, sir. No way. Nuh-uh. And further no more.
Guess this picnic can't get any worse. Wrong again.
I know I'm a bear of very little brain, but to me it seems so true that one is ever so much lonelier than two. Like bees without their honey, or a sun that isn't sunny, eat a cookie without milk. I wouldn't. And it seems that you can't wear just one shoe. You need a pair. Even if I wore them, which I don't, I couldn't.
Underneath the same sky, even though you're not close by, it feels just like we're right beside each other. Even though we're far apart, our friendship fills my heart. It's so good to know we're under the same sky. Every kind of game takes two, and I can't play without you. I guess I'd better put my ball away now. Even bouncing's not as funny, when you can't annoy your bunny. I'd fix things if I could just figure out how. It feels just like we're right beside each other. Even though we're far apart, our friendship fills my heart. It's so good to know we're under the same sky.
And though my head is full of fluff, this much I know is true. That's lonely on my only without you. Oh, no bother.
I know, Pooh. Having our friends separated like this is really sad.
Yes, I would so like things to be the way they were before they were how they are.
What we need is a plan.
A plan?
To bring us all back together.
Yes, a plan would be good if only we could come up with, that is, a plan.
I think I've got a plan.
You do? A plan that would bring us together?
If it works like it should, then I think that it would.
Would what?
Would bring us together.
A plan.
A plan.
I do so love a plan. And what might this plan be, Darby?
Why, that sounds like Darby.
Buster! Oh, did it hear? Has something happened to Buster, Pooh?
It seems that he is missing.
Missing what?
Himself. He appears to have, disappeared.
Buster's lost. This is awful.
Yes, it certainly is. And as mayor, I'll make sure that he gets found. My record for lost dogs is spotless, and I plan to keep it that way.
Rabbit, I think Buster might be somewhere on your side of the line.
You're more than welcome to come look for him, Darby.
And what about the rest of the super sleuths?
Might the super sleuths come and look for him, Mayor Rabbit?
Nope,
against the rules. Section 2, paragraph 3 clearly states a big...
Drastic situations sometimes call for drastic measures. And, seeing as how Buster could be in danger, I've decided to make an exception in this case. Therefore, I'm issuing a one-day pass for the super sleuths to pass. Onto this side, that is.
The mayor has issued the super sleuths a pass!
Yeah. Thank you, Beaver.
Thank you, Mayor Rabbit. And may I say, your grass is a lovely shade of green.
Thank you. Well, what are you waiting for, Tigger? You can come too.
Well, I don't know. I gotta do a fair amount of bouncing to, do my best sleuthing.
Fine, you can bounce all you want until Buster is found.
Oh, thanks, Rara, old pal. You were the bestest mayor in the whole thank you very much.
You're welcome, I'm sure. I also hereby proclaim that Rue and I will help the super sleuths look for Buster.
The mayor proclaims that he and Rue will...
Rabbit?
Yes?
We'd have a much better chance of finding Buster if Lumpy and Piglet can help, too.
Fine, fine. Everyone can have a one-time-only pass, but only to look for Buster. Thank you, Beaver. Well, let's get on with it.
Operation Find Buster has hereby begun.
Everyone working together. Now this is how it's supposed to be.
That way. The barking sounds like it's coming from the old cave.
Buster? It's me, Darby, and everyone. Come on out, boy.
Oh, it doesn't sound like it wants to come out.
Well, I guess we're just going to have to go inside and get him.
Inside? Oh, it's awfully dark.
And none of us brought a flashity light.
I think we're all going to have to think. Together. You too.
Now's the time to think. When you have a problem, think. Look at every clue like the super sleuths do and just think.
If only we had some rope.
Or a chain.
We could come back out of the cave safely.
And go in even safer.
But we don't have anything like that.
All we got is lots of friends.
That's it. A chain of friends. If we all hold hands, we can be just like a rope.
Well, it's a little crude, but it should work.
And none of us will get lost. Brilliant! Buster! Good boy.
All right, everybody, back it up. Nothing to see here. Come on now.
We got it! Yeah. That's great!
Aren't you two gonna shake hands?
Yeah, well, nice going, Grand Mayor Rabbit.
Yes, you too, other Mayor Tigger.
Great job, you guys! Our plan worked!
Oh, yes, it certainly did. And what was our plan again, Darby?
To pretend that Buster was lost, so that everyone would work together to find him.
Oh, yes, that plan. It did work rather well, didn't it?
You didn't mind at all, did you, boy? I knew that giving you that big bone would keep you busy.
Well, now that Buster has been found, I guess it's back to being on opposite sides of the line.
Well, that is what my rules say.
Goodbye, Rue. I sure had a lot of fun visiting you.
Bye, Lumpster. Maybe we can play catch across the line sometime.
You can visit more than once in a while, Lumpy.
Not really. Against your policy, you know.
My policy? My rules? Attention, everyone. I have an announcement.
Bear Rabbit says he has an announcement.
Thank you, Beaver. After great deliberation, I've decided I will no longer be mayor. Now, please, I don't want any objections or tears. Well, obviously you're all too overcome with shock and disappointment to react.
So, let me get this straight, long ears. You are un-electing yourself? So you're not the Big Cheese mayor anymore?
Correct.
But what about the big white line?
Don't worry, I know just what to do about that.
Family.
I got you.
And you got me.
Divided?
Never!
Friends!
Forever! One big happy family.
Someone who laughs when your jokes aren't funny.
Someone who makes rainy days seem sunny.
Someone who cares when you're feeling blue. I'm awfully glad I got friends like you.
Someone who knows all your ticklish spots.
Someone who has extra honey pots.
Someone who joins in your pirate crew.
Yes, I'm awfully glad I've got friends like you.
One
big happy
family.
I got you.
And you've got
me.
Divided?
Never.
Friends?
Forever. One big happy family. One big happy family. Yes,
we are one big happy family. The end.
Or is it?